Good afternoon. A new poll has shown the Coalition and Labor are sitting neck and neck as we inch closer to Election Day on Saturday. State political reporter Mark Santomartino joins me for more. Mark, the numbers show the two major parties on level pegging.
Steph, we always knew this one was going to be close. But yes, 4 days out from Victoria's election on November 26, Daniel Andrews and Matthew Guy are basically neck and neck. When it comes to the primary vote, this is the vote that you put down number one on your ballot paper. We'll bring it up for you on screen. You can see that both the Labor Party and the Liberal Party are locked at 36%. Now, how does that compare to the last time around in 2018? Well, Labor's vote was almost 43% and the Coalition's vote was 35%. You can see on screen, 10% of people are expected to vote for the Greens, another 6% for Independents and 12% for other Independents. Now, ultimately, what's the result going to be if this poll is replicated on November 26? Well, Labor would still win because the way the preferences flow, we are expecting the majority of those to head to Labor, and according to the Resolve Political Monitor, Labor is ahead 53 to 47, I should say, on a two-party preferred basis. As you may expect, given how much every single Victorian has seen of him over the past 8 years, Daniel Andrews is still leading the race as preferred Premier. We'll bring that up as well. 48% of Victorians surveyed would rather see him in the top job. 34% would rather see Matthew Guy. 18% are undecided, though, Steph. So how that firms up come Election Day on November 26 is anyone's guess. We've got 4 days to go.
Absolutely. Time will tell. And, Mark, Matthew Guy was out and about today but received a pretty hostile reception.
Yeah, he was meant to be out in the open on Birrung Ma announcing a plan for a $5 million start to a plan to essentially develop a park right next to Federation Square, Steph. He was meant to be outside, but members of the CFMEU turned up and that forced the Liberal leader to scramble inside to make his announcement. They were there. We're not exactly sure how they knew he was going to be there, but they turned up to chant, "Hands off our jobs."
Hands off our jobs! Hands off our jobs! Hands off our jobs!
He's going to cut the suburban rail loop. We're looking forward to building the suburban rail loop.
We're better than this. And we're better than the intimidation and the division that Daniel Andrews has created in this state.
Now, Steph, if the numbers are replicated like we saw in that poll, Matthew Guy cannot win. He needs to win an additional 18 seats, but the Liberal opposition leader is confident that the swing is on.
Thank you so much, Mark Santomartino, live from the newsroom. The Premier says Labor will write state-owned power into Victorian law if the party is given a third term in office. Heidi Murphy joins me live. And Heidi, Daniel Andrews wants the SEC enshrined into the Constitution.
Yeah, that's right, Steph. If re-elected, the Labor leader says that is what is absolutely needed in order to protect the SEC going into the future. He made the road trip down to Yallourn to make the point there that that plant is closing within 6 years and the SEC will have the job of finding the renewable energy to replace it. He wants to change the law to protect that.
It's going to be very difficult for the Victorian government to use it as a tool to lower power prices. It's going to be almost impossible.
If people choose lower power bills, more jobs, more skills and electricity that they own rather than profits to offshore companies, it'll be undeniable that we have a very clear mandate to get on and do this.
Was a business leader there questioning the SEC model, which is 51% government owned, the other 49% likely to be held in private hands, companies like super funds. The Premier was then rejecting any suggestion that the part ownership side will be out to make a profit at customer expense. Labor says this will all be up to voters to decide if it is the right next step.